I don't know about you guys, but today I'm feeling mathematical. So that is all I had planned for April Madness number 5, so from here on out, we're going freestyle. Heading to the Bibliocafe now to plan out what I'm going to say for this one. Have a few ideas in mind though, so don't be concerned. We're still going to get incredibly tropical. Mystic crystal revelation, and the mind's liberation. It doesn't show up on camera really well, but it's a classic raining West Coast day. Very damp, a lot of rainfall. All right, we got a plan. This is a 70-year-old book on the history and like an overview of what mathematics is. And I'm gonna go over a few things I found in there that I found interesting. It's more exciting than it sounds. And then I'm gonna rotate that into a presentation about conic sections that was from this book. So get excited, it's gonna be exciting. Classroom I usually film in is kind of an ugly classroom to film in, not that nice of an ambiance, so we're gonna go search around from classroom to classroom, try to find one that has a bit more of a video aesthetic. Okay, first attempt, room had someone in it. Wasn't actually that bad. Gonna give this a 4 out of 10. You got the exposed concrete. One window gives it a bit more points, but not bad. Lighting's not terrible. You have a big bank of windows. Not bad for points, but lighting, not very feng shui. It's very fluorescent. This one gets probably a max 5 out of 10.
Room numero 4.
And that's gonna be a no-go. You got windows, so not terrible, but fluorescent lighting. Roofing is that weird tiled roofing that's just incredibly ugly. Fluorescent lights, the black blackboard instead of the green blackboard, I'm kind of okay with. Everybody remember that stump? Throwback. Slug number 16. That one is just unfinished concrete. The bane of my existence. Building number 2. Nice arch. Couch could use some work. Nice painting on the wall. That definitely gets some points to this building, but again, we're gonna wait for the classroom. No windows, lighting's not terrible. A little vibey at the front there. It does have a neat little museum type vibe, but all in all, we're gonna give this one a 4 to 10 for the size. Maybe 3 to 10. Final building, this guy.
No.
It's locked!
All right, I think we're gonna have to default to one of the other rooms. Probably the one I was doing yesterday.
We're heading back to the classic. Defaulting back to the original classroom.
So I was reading this book, and there was just something absolutely hilarious in it. So this guy was a professor at Caltech a while ago. I mean, he wrote this book, it's like a general outline of math. Some of it's very confusing, but in all, it's just a general good overview. You can just like pick up the buzzwords. I kind of skim/read through it. Anyway, it's about circles. We're reading about circles. It is also of interest in passing to record that at least some of the early astronomers following Plato favored the circle on account of its supposed ideal perfection, not suspecting that a circle with its smug rotundity is little better than a geometrical platitude. A circle, no doubt, has a certain appealing simplicity at the first glance, but one look at an ellipse should have convinced even the most mystical of astronomers that the perfect simplicity of the circle is akin to the vacant smile of complete idiocy. I was laughing when I read that in the library, scared some people. His argument, if you can, I don't know if you can tell. So he goes over like how a circle is just a special case of an ellipse. I'll actually probably do another video on that. How you make an ellipse. I don't have the time to do that right now. It's like 9 o'clock. I gotta go home. I'm probably gonna get kicked out of the building I'm in, but I'm gonna leave you with something to ponder. It was in this book as well. I found it incredibly interesting. One sec. So this was never really taught to me. I think it was a bigger thing back in the day. Conic sections. So you take a cone, any arbitrary cone, and we're looking at how we intersect it. So we take a cone, right, and then we continue it basically all around. We continue the lines through. So it's like a big cone. It's like an infinite. It looks like an hourglass, like an infinite hourglass. But you take a cone, extend it like this, and extend it like this, right? And you go like that, and then you intersect with a plane, the cone. And you intersect it with a plane in different ways. So one example would be if you just had like the simple like plane like this. Like this would be a circle. If this is like flat, it would be like a circle intersecting the thing. So that the place where the plane intersects the cone would be a circle, and if you tilt it, it would be an ellipse, and there's a few, I don't want to give it away, but think to yourself what this would look like, because there's some really cool stuff. If you angle it the right way, it starts looking like perhaps a parabola? But play around with it in your mind. I thought it was kind of fun exercise, like seeing, there's a lot of different, like really interesting things you get from a cone. That's all. That's gonna wrap it up for this episode. Day number 5, checked off. Let's get tropical. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Start the movement, get in early. Bloomer math content, that's what we're doing here. Without further ado, take it easy, I love you. I will see you in the next one, which will be tomorrow. And Godspeed.